Hey guys, it's Dr. Rob.
Dr. Randy.
And we are the
Happy Healthy Guys.
Hey, we got it.
We did it. That's good. Nice job.
Absolutely.
Welcome back, everybody.
So, hey, you guys, thank you so much for watching this series. Hopefully, you guys are enjoying this today. We are going to be talking about myths, some of the things that you believe when it comes to your health. And those are some of the reasons why you're just not getting the health benefits that you want. But before we get into those myths, let's answer a question, okay?
Absolutely, and just right quickly about the myths, these are things that we also believed well before we actually had our epiphany. So it's not like they didn't get it and we did. We had to learn the hard way. We wanna make it easy for you, and we'll get there in a second, but like you said, let's go through, I think we had a good question from Mindy, correct?
Yeah, so Mindy said, hey, and you might be there as well, okay? Because this was me. She said, I'm eating all organic food.
Right.
I've been decreasing my calories, so I'm not eating very much.
Yeah, I think what she was keeping around 1,200 calories a day.
Which isn't very much.
Right, very low.
And she was exercising.
Yes.
A lot. And she was getting stuck. She couldn't lose any weight. She couldn't figure out why it is that she couldn't lose weight.
Yeah, so what we would say to that, and listen, by the way, that's a very common problem. And it's kind of like the whole eat.
Totally.
You know, you're like, you're eating less and moving more, and somehow it's supposed to create this incredible result. If you've ever watched The Biggest Loser, you know, they don't have a reunion show, right? Because you exercise and starve yourself, and the second you stop that, all the weight comes back. And so the whole eating less, moving more, your body will begin to adapt, so your metabolism will adapt to the cut in calories and increase in activity. And when it does this, your metabolism actually doesn't increase, it actually adapts and decreases. So Mindy, you're cutting calories and moving more. It's not necessarily calories in, calories out. It's what the foods you're eating, how they impact your body and how your hormones respond to what you're eating. And with our method, our Marbella method, we're gonna talk about and release and go through step by step, we're gonna show you how to move your body into fat burning versus sugar burning based off what you're eating. And when your body's burning fat, your metabolism never gets sluggish and it continues to get better and better and better.
Which is awesome, because that brings us into the myths, because one of the myths that's out there is that, you know what, it's gotta be my age. That's why my metabolism is slowing down. It's because I'm getting older, my metabolism is slowing down. Well, you know what that tells me? That means it's gonna suck to get older. Right?
Right.
But a lot of people believe that, right?
Well, we're both the oldest we've ever been, which we always kid about, and yet we're happier and healthier than we've ever been. So if age determined how healthy you can be, then everybody older than you should be sicker than you. And everybody younger than you should be healthier than you, and it's just not true. Plus, you can't change your age, but we can definitely change how you adapt to your environment, chemically, physically, and emotionally, and that's the most important thing.
So there's definitely a solution for that, right?
There is a solution. I wish we could say, hey, we're the age doctors, and we can make you go from 57 to physiologically and chronologically 27. We cannot do that. If we were, we'd probably be the most famous doctors in the world. That's just not possible.
That's true. Well, the truth of the matter, and we're going to give you guys some real-life examples of some people whose metabolic age was actually older than them, right?
Yeah, you actually can change your physiological age. Yeah. I guess what I was saying is we can't fix the chronological.
Yeah, you can't fix that.
Yeah, you can't fix that. That would be pretty cool.
Yeah, my birthday's tomorrow, and we're not stopping that.
No.
Right? It's still going to happen. So, but the cool thing is, yeah, I'm happier and healthier than ever before.
Yeah, and then, you and me both, buddy.
Awesome.
Amen.
Okay, so next another myth is age. Oh, we said age, right?
Yes.
So not age, but gender. And so so whether, you know, you're male or you're female, a lot of people have been taught or they believe that, well, because I'm female, then, well, I'm obviously then supposed to gain weight as I get older.
Yeah, listen, obviously there's huge differences between men and women. But listen, it's not necessarily what gender you are, because I could show you handfuls of our patients that are men and women. And likewise, you could show handfuls of men and women who are not our patients. And there's really no rhyme or reason why one person's healthy based off of gender. A lot of that will tie into genetics. People think it's like, well, it's my genes, and you know, I was born into this family, and this is how I'm gonna have to express health, when we know the research supports not genetics or gender, but epigenetics, which is how you turn on your genes or express your health based on how you adapt to your environment, like we talk about, chemically, physically, and emotionally, and how well your body can heal and function. So you can overcome your genes. You're not a victim to your genes. And just for the record, we don't do any genetic testing. And a lot of our greatest success stories with our patients are people that aren't considered to be the most genetically healthy people in the world, yet miraculously, did I even say that right? Miraculously.
You did. Actually, I was impressed.
Miraculously, they overcome their bad genetics and create outrageous health. If they can do it, you can too. And if we can overcome what we overcame with our bad genes, it won't tell the ultimate story, and you have control over that.
Yeah, because a lot of people say, and this ties perfectly into that, is that it's my hormones, or it's dieting and exercising. Like, I've been dieting forever, or I've been exercising a lot, and I think that right there is a perfect segue into Ryan, right?
Yeah, well, we're going to go to Ryan. Let's touch this briefly, because I know that that's a big thing with diet and exercise. A lot of you listening and the people we've consulted, they're like, listen, I really don't deserve to be happy and healthy or at my ideal weight or expressing great health because I don't eat right or exercise enough. Or, you know, maybe you're on hormones, your doctor's done tests, and your hormones are out of balance, you've got a thyroid issue. Ultimately, hormones are a big thing, especially with women, but with men too. But it's not one thing. You know, a lot of times we focus on the sex hormones when there's a whole cascade of hormones. Adrenaline, cortisol, leptin, glucagon, insulin. It's balancing all the hormones with the strategies that we're gonna reveal. We're gonna show you how to balance your hormones naturally and overcome any of these maybe preconceived notions that it's completely a hormone issue that you can't change, or that you need synthetics, or even that, hey, that you don't eat right, and maybe you don't, but I know people who don't eat right, and they're quote healthy, and I know people who do eat right, and they struggle like crazy. I know people who never exercise, and they're still skinny. I know people who pound the treadmill, and they can't lose a pound. So it's just not diet, exercise, or hormones. It's a really a lot bigger than that. And ultimately, it boils down to how well does your body handle stress? How is your metabolism? Those are things you can directly influence, and we're going to show you how.
Yeah, so we're gonna let you watch this right here, because this is Ryan. So I've known Ryan for years, and I anytime I would see Ryan, he'd always be
asking you health questions.
Asking me health questions, right? That's kind of being in the health industry, just kind of what happens. And he'd go, "Hey, Rob, so I got this issue going on. I can't figure out how come I can't lose weight." And it always came back around to the same thing. And I'm like, "Hey, you know what? We've got this method. Randy and I've got this method. If you just do it, you try it. All you got to do is just do it.
Yes,
it'll work for you." And so here's Ryan's story and him sharing you how what it is that we're talking to you guys about, how it worked for him, and if it worked for him, it can work for you too.
My name's Ryan Young, and I'd like to tell you guys about my experience with the Happy Healthy Guys, Rob and Randy. I originally started talking with them because I had tried everything to lose weight and was finding no success. After playing football in the NFL with three different teams, the New York Jets, the Houston Texans, and the Dallas Cowboys, I realized that I had access to some of the best healthcare professionals in the world. And I thought that I had a good understanding of how to maintain a healthy diet and lifestyle. Unfortunately, everything that I was doing was not working for me. When I met Rob and Randy, I was in a season of frustration and I was extremely discouraged because I was dealing with some hip and knee injuries that caused me to retire from the NFL, and I was in desperate need to lose weight. And after consulting with Rob and Randy, I was able to follow their game plan and lose 30 pounds. And the good news is that after following their recommendations, not only am I able to keep the weight off, I'm able to maintain a healthy lifestyle. Man, I want to thank the Happy Healthy Guys, Rob and Randy, and their team. Man, you guys have helped save my life and change the quality of my life, which has spilled over into my life as a husband, a father, and just a servant in the community. I love you guys. I appreciate what you do. You just keep on changing people's lives. Man, thank you.
All right, how cool was that? So there's Ryan.
Super cool.
Yeah, who thought that, you know, NFL football player.
Right, had access to all the best doctors in the world, yet he still struggled. There was really no answer for him. And it was pretty cool because he almost was like, this was too easy. You made it too simple. Although it really wasn't easy, we did make it simple, but he decided to take action, and I thought his story was so cool how he shared it. He has such a great heart, and I couldn't be happier for Ryan and his success and how he inspires us and others. If you heard his story, you have to be inspired.
Yes, he's definitely an inspirational person. I love how he put that in there, because a lot of times we forget about this part, but what he put in there at the end was how this has made such a difference as a husband,
right,
and as a yes. father, and we don't realize how big of an impact our health has on us. Yep. And that right there is a good example of how it does. And that right there should really be our why, is so that we can be able to be healthier and better for other people. Right?
Yeah, it's like you say, it's just really not about us. We have people who depend on us, and being the healthiest version of yourself is the greatest thing you can do for the people that depend on you. And Ryan's a perfect example of that.
Yeah, he is. So let's review
all right.
what we talked about last week. So we talked last week about stress, and we gave you guys some homework. One of the homework assignments was gratitude. Did you do your five?
I hate homework, but I love the benefits of gratitude.
Okay.
So I did my homework. Awesome. I did my gratitude. I stay in gratitude. Did you do your gratitude? Dr. Rob, did you do your gratitude?
Absolutely, I did. You know, this is one of the things that I put into practice
every
single day, and it's been one of the things that really has changed my life. It really has changed my outlook on things.
Yeah, don't wake up in the morning and start checking Facebook. You're going to be stressed out like crazy or going straight to your email. Start with gratitude first before you do anything else, or it may not happen, and you're going to start off in the wrong way.
Yeah, absolutely. And the second thing that we said along with gratitude was getting an accountability partner. So if you're watching today because somebody sent this to you, well, then that means that somebody or that person cares and loves you enough to send this and share this with you. If you didn't share it with somebody else, I'm not judging, but I'm just saying, right?
Like, what's your deal?
Yeah, exactly. So, no, we want to make sure that you're held accountable. And yeah. You know what? If you didn't, you know what? That's okay. Use us as your accountability partner.
Right.
Right?
So, yeah, we're in your corner. We talk about that. The happy, healthy guys. We believe in you. We believe everybody, including you, need to be happy and healthy. And you just got to give yourself permission to take that accountability, nourish yourself. We're right here with you.
Absolutely.
Because we're preaching, you know, really to ourselves every time we do something like this.
Absolutely. So, Happy Healthy Guys on Facebook, you can ask us whatever questions that you want. And so, whatever question that you have, it's going to help somebody else as well.
Yes.
So, definitely do that. So, let's start teaching them about other things that we learned while we were there in Spain. So, we talked about the stress thing. So, let's talk about three things that we found when it came to just food or eating or the way that you eat that we noticed while we were in Spain.
Yeah, they're really simple things, but once again, our epiphany was like huge for us.
Yeah.
Because it's just things we just had not really applied living here in the States. So one of those were, we saw that they ate a lot of healthy fat over in Spain. And really, a part of the Mediterranean diet and that culture, they do eat a lot of healthy fat. And we know the benefits of eating healthy fat are long and lengthy. Remember, fat helps you burn fat. It nourishes the nervous system, the brain, helps support all the formation of hormones in your body. You can't even absorb certain fat-soluble vitamins like A, D, E, and K without healthy fats. So healthy fats are essential to the body, your health, your immune system, your brain, and preventing chronic illness. And I think in America, we've been taught for so many years to avoid fat, right? Mm-hmm. To go low fat or no fat, and we're now more obese and more chronically ill than we've ever been as a society, so something's wrong.
Yeah.
And I think for us, seeing there, adding the healthy fats, eating the lamb, which is a beautiful, rich, fatty meat, they ate a lot of dairy products from sheep, which we'll talk about more. We saw them eating, especially with the dairy, their dairy's not from cow, or hormone-based, antibiotic-based cows fed grain. These are from sheep and goat that are naturally pastured. So a lot of the fats we found they were eating are obviously SCT oil,
which is short-chain triglycerides.
Yes, short-chain fatty acids are short-chain triglycerides, and these are some of the best fats you can put in your body that you can find in these type dairy products. Unfortunately, a lot of you may be sensitive to dairy, or you may be used to the dairy you get access to in America that's not genetically correct and can be filled with hormones and toxins. So we're obviously talking about a pure SCT oil that is completely absorbable, gives butyric acid, which is the preferred source of fuel for your colon, for your gut. It burns crazy amounts of fat. It gives your body ready-made ketones that your body can use directly for energy. And for those of you who struggle with digestion or your gallbladder or your liver, these fats require no bile, no pancreatic activity. So it goes right into your system for energy, for nourishing the brain, and for burning fat and increasing your metabolism, which is why we've really been excited about the SCT oil. But we saw in Spain, a lot of them were eating these type fats, and we saw the results because, the obesity rate had to be low. We don't have the numbers, but just visually.
I don't remember seeing an overweight person there, and it was like they were eating all of this food.
I know.
You know, and they're not fat, and they're not obese. It was crazy. So that was eye-opening.
Yes.
For me, which brings us to the next.
Right, because they were eating less. Mm-hmm. They were eating less often.
So they were eating more or less often.
Right, they weren't waking up first thing in the morning and cramming in a donut and a Mountain Dew and a bowl of cereal. A lot of times they weren't eating till later in the day. And when they were eating, they were taking time to enjoy their food, right? It wasn't like this race to see who could finish first and get back to work. It was really more of an event. It was like a 2 to 3 hour event where you're chewing slowly, you're digesting your food, you're eating those real foods. And then once again, they were eating dinner, 8, 9, 10 o'clock. So really almost like two really rich, nutritious, nutrient-dense meals in a day. So once again, they weren't eating less, they were just eating less often. And I think for us, we began to see like, wait a second, in America, we snack all the time.
No, from the very time that we wake up in the morning, first thing that we do is we eat.
Yes.
And then we eat again at 10 a.m.,
yep.
Again at lunchtime, again at 2, again at 4,
right.
Again
most
at
of us,
6.
The thought of skipping a meal, you almost would rather be dead because your blood sugar is going to drop so low and you get hangry,
yep.
Where you're hungry and angry, but it's a real neurological problem. You should be able to go easily 5 hours without eating. If you can't already do that, you're already pre-diabetic or maybe already diabetic and headed down the road of chronic inflammatory disease because your body's dependent on burning sugar for energy versus fat. And there's a big difference there.
So what we notice really then is shortening the feeding windows or tightening them up.
Yes.
And eating your, what we say is breaking our fast later,
yeah,
our break
it is fast, the most important meal of the day.
Just at 11 or 12 o'clock.
But what are you breaking your fast with? If it's sugar, if it's cereal, if it's milk, if it's grain, if it's diet sodas or the real sodas, if it's a donut,
exactly.
If it's a latte filled with syrup, you're breaking your fast with sugar and training your body to always need sugar, which is inflammatory, which is going to wreck your hormones and cause you to be tired, crabby, and not feel your best. Am I hitting any hot buttons there with how you feel?
So eat more.
Yes.
Just
eat less often.
Eat less often. Okay.
Yeah, which I think will bring us to our next point.
Which is the toxins?
Well, yeah, it's really eliminating toxins, but one of the best ways to eliminate toxins is start to eat real food that's not filled with toxins.
Exactly.
So when we were in Spain, we noticed that people were eating real foods. It's like our great friend Dr. Emmett Blahnik, who says you want to surf, right? Simply eat real food. That's what they do there. So you're eating fruits and vegetables and farm to table. Lamb, in fact, they drank more wine than anybody I know, yet they were healthier than most people that I know who maybe would avoid it. And we're not saying drink a lot of wine. What we're saying is there was a real balance there of eating real foods and eliminating a lot of the toxic foods that you can see. So we didn't see high fructose corn syrup there. Their ketchup was free of that. And the condiments, they're handing out packets of extra virgin olive oil. They were giving you more healthy fats versus giving you, the sweet and low, the sucralose, the saccharin, all the other chemicals. So you must begin to take accountability of what's going in your body, what you're putting on your body, and that starts with starting to eat real food. And real food is quite simple. If it doesn't go bad in 7 to 10 days, it's probably not real food.
Yeah, exactly. If it doesn't go bad in that time period and or you can't pronounce what's in it,
you gotta Google the chemical compound that's in your food.
Not real food.
Not real food. If it's built to last the next 1,000 years and stay fresh, not food. If it's bleached, colored, deodorized, preserved, and put in a box or a can, in many cases, those foods are inflammatory and the body can't recognize them, and it is a toxin.
The body doesn't recognize, and here's what happens physiologically, is it goes into the colon, and the colon immediately takes those toxins, and it stores it inside your body, and it stores it inside fat cells. So what you're essentially doing is you're putting your body into fat storage rather than fat burning, and none of us want that.
No.
That's why eliminating toxins is such a huge deal. So if we take this from a practical standpoint, just to show you guys that this isn't something that's theoretical, it's real.
Yes.
And we look at all the myths that we just got through talking about. I'm gonna post this up there, but I want you to see myself before going to Spain.
Yes.
And then after going to Spain, you guys can see the before and after picture. The before is 65 pounds heavier than the after.
Right.
And all I did is what it is that we've been talking about, and you guys can be able to see the results there.
It's crazy.
It is crazy.
Before and after. I can't even believe, I look at you now and you're so healthy, it's almost hard to believe what you were not that long ago. And it really was that easy by adding these steps that we're talking about. So let's definitely post that before and after.
It'll be up right now. Okay. So let's make this practical.
Yes.
Okay, so three things that they can do, because we always give homework. I know you love homework. But we gotta make
it. Is there a better way to, can we call it something else besides homework?
Let's call it Upwork, right?
Upwork.
Yeah, fun work.
Fun work. Okay. Here's your fun work.
It's the fun work, okay? So number one is to stop snacking.
Yes.
That was a tough one for me, but you know what? If I can do it, you can totally do it. Here's the cool thing is that once I stopped snacking, and then I did the next thing that we're gonna add in, I really didn't have any craving or feel like I wanted to snack on the sugary foods or the salty foods, the chips, those kind of things.
No, and I've got a funny story. It's really not funny, it's sad, but you know, before cancer, I used to snack and eat all day long, you know, 5, 6, 7 meals a day, cramming all the food, the protein, to try to bulk my body, working out, trying to be healthy, eating organic, right into a cancer diagnosis. So I remember I always had this nasty sugar addiction, right? And I could never fix it because I would try to just willpower this thing into submission. So my longest run ever without eating ice cream was about 9 months. And I told myself, you will not eat ice cream. And I dug in, I drew a hard line in the sand, and I'm like, you're not gonna do it. And I did it for 9 months, which is, almost, that's kind of impressive. At least I'm impressed. But guess what happened in about 9 months? I went on a 21-day bender of eating ice cream pint after pint after pint for 21 days in a row because my body was craving it so bad, because when you snack, you secrete insulin. So you keep secreting insulin all day long, which is triggering your brain to want more sugar, more carbs, and more ice cream. So literally, I could coin the 21-day ice cream method.
Having to gain
20
it.
Pounds and wreck your immune system in just 21 days.
So don't snack.
No, so they're not snacking though is the key thing here. Because we talk about moving people into a ketabolic shift. And a ketabolic shift is very simply moving your metabolism over to getting its energy requirements from fat versus sugar. And when that shift happens,
which is the second thing that we got to add in there.
Yes.
We got to eat healthy fats.
Right. So in order to do that, you got to quit snacking. You got to tighten up those windows, and you got to start adding those healthy fats. Keep your carbohydrates clean, low sugar fruits, fibrous vegetables, moderate protein, and tons of healthy fat. So things like avocado and avocado oil, olives, which, dear Lord, I've never seen more beautiful olives than we did in Spain. The brightness and the green of that olive oil was phenomenal. So real olive oil.
Gorgeous.
Yeah, the dark chocolate, about 80% cacao or higher. Perfect fat for fat burning and for the immune system and for mental clarity. It is the feel-good fat. We're also talking about, coconut oil, grass-fed butter, ghee. Obviously, our SCT oil is one of the richest sources of short chains, and it's fat burning and great for the gut. Germinated or raw nuts and seeds like pecans, almonds. What are some of my favorites? Pecans, almonds, walnuts, or germinated or raw pumpkin seeds or sunflower seeds. Chia seeds, fresh ground flax seeds, hemp seeds. Those are all great fats with tons of fiber antioxidants, and tons of nutrients that you can nourish your body with. Am I missing any, Dr. Rob?
I think we're good. Scoot over that way just a second so they can be able to see that. Okay, so you can screenshot that if you need
Perfect.
To. Perfect. As far as the oils go.
Yeah, so you got to add the healthy fats. You got to tighten up those windows. Quit being dependent on insulin. You got to eliminate the fake food, right? So replace fake food with real food, right? So instead of having a canned applesauce, eat a real apple. Are you with?
Definitely want to make sure that we're simply eating real food, just like Dr. Emmett talks about, because when we're doing that and we're adding that, we're not snacking, we're eating healthy fats, eliminating the fake foods, then we're getting into that ketabolic shift.
Right, and that ketabolic shift is a game changer. And essentially what we're talking about is when your metabolism, your energy requirements to run life, move from burning sugar to burning fat. And when that happens, the benefits are outstanding, because when you burn fat, you're going to get more mental clarity. You're going to sleep better. You're going to have less pain. You're going to have more energy. You're going to feel more like you, versus burning sugar where you're tired, you're cranky, you're hungry. You don't sleep well, you're inflamed, and you never feel your best. So that shift is critical, not only to have a healthy metabolism, but to feel well, prevent disease, reduce your inflammation. And once again, just feel more like you. If you don't feel your best, I can promise you, you're burning sugar and you're not burning fat.
Yeah, so that's why it's important that we make sure that you guys watch the next video, because yes, we're gonna go over how to be able to make sure that it's simple for you, you're getting these benefits, and we're gonna introduce you guys to somebody who's just like you, who's right, had an amazing transformation. We're gonna show you how this person did it. It's gonna blow your mind. So what you wanna make sure that you do is you share this also with other people, because they're going to want to see this as well. It can literally change and save their yes, life. So share it with other people. Make sure that you guys open the next video. It's the last video in the series. It's going to wrap everything together.
Right.
So you guys have what it is you guys need to be able to really start living this lifestyle that, that we've been living for a long time.
Yeah, I mean, our epiphany from our time in Spain, we, like I said, we came back and we really built out this framework to make things easy to follow. We've made it foolproof so you can get an incredible result in the shortest amount of time possible. So like Dr. Rob said, do not miss the next video. We're gonna take you through the next step. We're gonna reveal a powerful testimony like Ryan's and go through more of the benefits and how you can begin to, or not begin to, but continue, because I know you're gonna do your fun work, to take action and keep getting the result we want you to get.
Yeah, absolutely. So you guys, we'll see you on the next video. You guys have a great day.
Yes.
Dr. Rob.
I'm Dr. Randy.
We're the
Love you guys. We're the Happy Healthy Guys.
Happy Healthy Guys, exactly. Right. Talk to you guys soon.